Hello, welcome to the Hockaday Museum of Art in Kalispell, Montana. I'm Lois Lyford and I will be conducting the tour, the virtual tour, of our Members Salon 2020. Let's begin with our black and white section. The first two are photographs, one by Roselle Mosteller entitled Vortex, and then the second right behind me is one that is called Serpentine Tree, and it's by Greg Thurston. And then down the stair a bit here, we have Karen Brown's drawing titled Blaisdell Barn. Now moving into color, we have Sherry Nagy with her Cascades of Virginia Creek. And following that, the Serenity of Michelle Lopez's Golden Light over Avalanche. This is a watercolor by Charlene Payne, and it's of an old farmhouse that was built in 1910. Charlene likes to do these kinds of paintings for her friends. This next watercolor by Carrie Keefe is a portrait of a little boy, and she's named it The Best Medicine. Since most of the paintings here today are in oil, I will mention when they aren't, and this is the first one that is acrylic. It's by Gail Kennedy, entitled Sunset Over Big Mouth. Thomas Lewis gives us a wonderful view of a silver-tip cub, and that's the title of this work. This photograph by James Duncan is titled As Falls McDonald, So Falls, McDonald's Falls. John Chavanavelt has used oil to display this Tanzanian mission compound. He uses a very different perspective. And next is Laura Newstead's Winter Orchid. This orchid is done in amazingly bright colors, and she has used it in such a way that it has become an abstract. It's acrylic. This work is by Carol Babington, and it's done with cold wax and oil. Cold wax is combined with a solvent, and then it becomes kind of like a malleable wax. And when the pigment is added, even more so. So then she can shape these forms and put lines in them and layer them with color and suggest then movement. Nancy Kallmeyer Harrington has created this quarantine landscape, she called it, from wool fiber, which is hand spun and plant dyed. Marnell Brown, in her Crossing the Summit, which is oil, has used palette knife, and a very limited palette, very soft palette. And Tabby Ivy entitled hers Near Augusta, which again is oil, but in a tonalism style where everything is kind of soft and blends together, no rough edges. Next is Russ Tanner, and his is called Buck Mountain. Some landscape include people, horses, buildings, and that's the case here. She has depicted these kids beginning their adventure in life. And this is Stephanie Klein, and this is located near Ronan. Whereas in this one, we see just a wonderful old farmhouse with the Mission Range as the backdrop. The artist is Nan Smalley, and this is located on Old Highway 93. Okay, I'm still with you folks, but my shadow is a problem, so I'm stepping back so you can focus on the artwork. Darlene Morgan, with these two children, has titled it On the Fence, and Darlene has been drawing for years and prefers to use India ink wash. But this is a one-of-a-kind medium. So is this next piece. This medium, egg tempura, could have been used by the old masters, but Luke Auersland has put it to good advantage with capturing this child, and his title is Wonder Weeks. Now we're going to see three landscapes, all with different medium. The first is watercolor by Rusty Wells, and it's titled Dead Drift. The photographer, Don Harreberg, has called his piece fireweed at the bend. He says he likes mountains, but he likes them when he has colorful wildflowers at their knees. Next is Teresa Evie's Swan River Dance, and Teresa took first prize in this show. And how she got to be first prize is everybody that looked at the whole show was given a slip of paper and they could vote for any piece of art that they chose. Our next section deals with clouds and sky and atmosphere, and the one on the left by Susan Oursland is entitled The Dust of His Feet. She likes her emphasis to be on the clouds rather than the surrounding scenery, whereas Noel Drury, his depiction of the flatted view has much color in the sky as well as color in the foreground. And Jean Hand Trio uses watercolor in this damp, foggy morning. She entitles it Deep Silence, and she said she was giving her osprey a lunch break. We have a lot of variety in our show today. And sometimes one of the things that draw people to notice one next to the other, something that will tie them together, is color. And that's what we'll be approaching in these next three pieces of art. The first one, with the homeless couple under the umbrella there, as painted by Karen Lee in watercolor, was on location in Rome. She saw this couple comforting one another on some steps near a church. And so she was inspired to title it Pietà from Michelangelo's wonderful work of the same name. And then following along with those same colors and floral designs, we have Gaily Running Links with Mixed Media with her fun piece she titled A Little Feline Luck with a question mark. We are even carrying that same color of kind of the orangey look over into Sally Vannoy's wonderful depiction of sand cranes, which she has entitled Wetland Royals. And from here on down the rest of the wall, there will be a combination of landscapes interspersed with wildlife. And so we'll just have a go. The first thing we see is Bonnie Gardner's McDonald Creek, not at the flood of spring, but in the peace of summer. And here we have Terrell Jones's pelican. And if you look at that bird's eye, you're going to know why he titled it what he did. He said, really? You can't dock your boats here. Ronald Prestwich and his wife, Susan, hang around together in life, so they're hanging together here as well. And this one by Ronald Prestwich is Sunset Fields, using wonderful complementary colors. And his wife, Susan Prestwich, is using watercolor in the more traditional tones. The title of his is Sunset Fields, hers is The Falls Dreams. Below them we find Dixie Turner, who has shown us the beautiful way of going into the cedars. She's titled it Ross Creek Cedars. Then Sandra Marker, another McDonald Falls picture, has done hers in watercolor, and it's beautiful, the colors she's got there going for her water. Linda Lee Cleveland has oil on this picture. It's called Flathead Fall. That speaks for itself, as does Barbara Manley's An Uncommon View. Very seldom do you see Wild Goose Island in St. Lawrence Lake depicted from this view. Well, guess who has caught himself a wonderful lunch? Tammy Phillips has titled this one Wild Caught Salmon Lunch, and it's a delightful watercolor. Our next two pieces are dealing with fog, atmospheric effects, and Bobby Hafer has titled hers In and Out of the Fog. And when we come to Kristen Vandenberg's, she has also called hers fog effect. The Nagatala-like light is more predominant in this one and more subtle tones in that one, but they so are beautiful with those fog effects. In this grouping of three landscapes, we'll begin with Sunny LeBlanc's Rocks, Water, and Joy. Sunny is a docent here and we miss her. She's not with us in the winter. This landscape by David Hafer is entitled House Gall 1912. And you see it is a landscape, but it has a story to tell because that's a country doctor making a house call. And in this one, we have the only pastel in the exhibit. It's by Francesca Dahl and it's Stepping Up at Wayfarers Park. Susan Guthrie gives us a wonderful example of luminism in this beautiful landscape, which she has titled Whisper on the Water. Now in using a totally different kind of palette, Wanda Mum, with her Autumn Grand View, lifts up color and more color. We're viewing Lusitano, Stallion Spain by Karen Young, who is our second place winner. And I don't know that anybody could get more realistic than this. He's going to whinny any moment, I'm sure. Here we have two cowboy motifs. Jessica Glenn is our third place winner, and she has chosen to use watercolor on ledger paper. She certainly is effective, and it's called Grace and Company. And next to her is Carl Ortman's depiction titled Cowboy. Now again in sepia tones, this is an acrylic, and it's titled Sleeping Lady Mountain, which is a portion of a range of mountains northwest of Anchorage. And the artist is Lois Leifert. And moving over here, we have the only sculpture, and it's absolutely beautiful. It has marvelous lines. Some have said that it might be reminiscent of Art Deco days 100 years ago. And I've said, I think maybe Ken's going to go fishing in Texas where everything is much, much bigger. Here, this watercolor by M.K. Ingwaldson is called Rustic Railings. And she picked it, she said, because she likes to bring out the extraordinary in the ordinary. Just some old pieces of fence that were stacked together. She used all those beautiful shadows to just do that. Now we will see two very different landscapes. One in photography by Michael Evans, which he has entitled Rocky Mountain Aspens 2020. The very vibrant colors and the mixture and the light. But move with me around the corner. Now you see acrylic on canvas by Levon Burgard. She calls hers Focus on Fall, and it was taken when she was doing some plein air work up in the McDonald area. And she centered on this group of trees, and again has used wonderful complementary colors. This piece by Monique Kleinhans is entitled Whispers in the Grass, and she's using wool and a process called needle felting, and there is quilting in the background. We're going to close with a variety, three different mediums. This one is an oil by Rob Akey, and it's a miniature, we call them, and it's Evening Stroll in the Sweetgrass. And finally, we have Jack Dykstra's beautiful watercolor entitled Bird of Paradise, and also then Linda Hendrickson's Eye Popper, done in mixed media. Thank you for joining us. We hope to see you in person soon. And until then, if you don't have a membership with us, we'd love to have you join us. It's the best bargain in town.